Wagwan YouTube, Fickod here. Welcome to another Destiny video. Today, we're going to be going over yet another Destiny 2 leak. Yes, that is right, even after the official trailer drop, we're still getting leaks. This leak originates from a GameStop employee who posted two images on Reddit of some documents he was sent by Activision and Bungie, which essentially aim to inform employees on what Destiny 2 is going to be about, you know, so they can better assist customers and stuff. It's pretty standard in retail. The documents leaked actually give us some insight into Destiny 2's story and even its DLC plan, so very interesting today. But just before we jump in, if you do enjoy this video, find it informative in any way, then a like would be appreciated, but your viewing and enjoyment is enough for me. So let's jump in. I'll have the documents on screen, but I'm not going to read them in full, I'm just going to read the most interesting parts. So first off, the document says that Activision are aiming to make Destiny 2 the largest entertainment launch of the year. So that is absolutely insane. That means bigger than any other game, any other movie, you know, bigger than the Switch release, anything like that, which is absolutely crazy. And if I'm honest, they're on track to be probably the biggest game release of the year, but not necessarily the biggest entertainment release. So it will be interesting to see how Activision up their game and handle that. I mean, we have actually started seeing, especially me in my local stores, Destiny 2 regalia being painted all over the walls, and I can tell you it's getting me very, very hyped, so it is working. The next interesting part of this first document is the quote, "We're telling a new story about Guardians and the battle to defend their home. Favorite characters are set to return, and players are set to meet new characters on their voyage." So what that's telling me is obviously the fact Cade, Zavala, Ikora are returning, but also that we'll be meeting new significant characters, most notably the new Hawthorne character that was sort of semi-leaked on the actual pre-order page for Destiny 2 within the Collector's Edition, and that does appear to be setting her up for quite a big role. The paragraph continues and says, "The action will explode through a cinematic campaign, and that will lead players to new worlds and back again." Which for me sounds absolutely amazing, I can't wait. Maybe we'll go see Europa, and then maybe we'll get back and have a raid in the last city or something, that'd be epic. Hopefully though, we'll get cutscenes to the level that we've been seeing the trailers, but that might be wishful thinking. Next and finally for this first document, it says, "All year long, we'll be revealing new threats and new places to explore, and new ways for Guardians to fight. Our first destination will be our own event dedicated to Destiny, where we'll be unveiling our bold plans for the future." So to me, that sounds like DestinyCon, which if you didn't know, is a title Bungie copyrighted a few months back, listed as a name for a convention. If you want the ins and outs and all that, I'll have my video on that, that I made a while back, in the description. It's very, very interesting. Essentially, they copyrighted the name DestinyCon, and this is where I think they'll be announcing plans beyond the first two expansions, which we'll get onto in a minute. Very interesting. The document states that players will not require any prior knowledge to play Destiny 2. So does that mean that there'll be some sort of cutscene or cinematic at the beginning of the game that is just going to sort of summarise the whole of Destiny 1? Well, that is a possibility. Or it could mean, in my opinion, the more likely option is that Destiny 2 is going to have a very isolated storyline that will feel very separate to Destiny 1, bar obviously a few characters returning or nods to the previous game. In my opinion, that is more likely. The next interesting part of the second document is the topic of expansions. Saving the best for last here, it talks about the expansion pass. And it says, "The Destiny 2 expansion pass includes reservations for both expansion 1 and expansion 2, which will be released in winter 2017 and spring 2018. So if you didn't know, the expansion pass is actually viewable on the pre-order page for Destiny 2, revealing the banners for these first and second expansions. And it looks like as if the Osiris-themed expansion 1 is coming winter 2017, so very close actually to the initial launch of Destiny 2 at September 8th, just like Dark Below was with Destiny 1 2014, which I've always found really odd to release DLC in December, because that means all the people getting Destiny at Christmas are like going to miss out on, you know, going to have to then buy Destiny and then the DLC. I just always thought that's a little bit weird. But also, the Rasputin themed expansion 2 looks like it's coming in spring 2018, which is again similar to House of Wolves, which came out early 2015. So it is following very closely to the Destiny 1 season pass. And my bet is that at the end of 2018, we'll get another Taken King sized expansion. But I have actually spoke about this before in my Destiny 2 DLC theory video. I made that quite a while back. I do recommend you go and see it, as I have actually been quite right so far, not to toot my own horn. But anyway, that's about it for today's video. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you enjoyed this video or found it informative in any way, a like is always appreciated, as is a cheeky share, but your viewing and enjoyment is enough for me. So you've had a lot of interesting information in this video, a lot to take in. The leaks haven't got a lot of context or consistency, they're just key details. So we've got the expansions coming at the end of the year, and then our second expansion coming the earlier, so that's quite a solid content flow. Are we going to have live events in between that? Well, it looks like it, but I spoke about that in previous videos again. They'll all be linked below. But if you'd like to stay up to date with Destiny 2 and the Destiny universe in general, then may I recommend you hit that subscribe button. And while you're down there, may I suggest you hit the bell to be notified on my uploads, just so you don't miss a thing. But actually, just before I go, may I remind all of you that tonight at 8 PM GMT, I'm going to be streaming for the first time ever right here on YouTube with a whole bunch of other streamers, so it's going to be great fun. I'd recommend you come and check it out. All the details will be in the description, down below. Check them out, because it's going to be fun, boys and girls. anyway, I've been Fickod the Man. I hope you enjoyed. Until the next time, guys. Bye-bye.